Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another episode of Total War Tiller with me, your host, of course, leading the glorious Western Roman Empire into combat against evil barbarians and other nasty things. We are so far here finding our borders slightly penetrated, having to deal with more and more things, rebels and other nasty separatists as well. So far, things are certainly looking a bit struggling. We'll be just throwing on some additional men here to support the Imperial unit here. Yes, they do pack a bit more punch and aren't quite as in trouble. In a sense, we're going to sort of leave that, I think, a bit on its own for the time being. Though, of course, we're captured back. We got some barbarians sneaking about here. Army's moving down there. Need to reinforce this one, by the way. Don't have any more money for that, though, so that's a bit unfortunate. Of course, we're also coming down here to deal with additional troublemakers down there. I mean, overall, sort of chipping away at several points here, and we are struggling to contain it and to push back the enemies of Rome. That's overall a lot of fun, if you will. Somewhat. And there's certainly going to be a lot more work involved with that. Of course, we'll quickly check if there's anything we can sort of further do to...
I am sure you have many pleasant...
Strengthen our position somehow.
Speak quickly and well.
Again, just some quick attempts at trade, just to see if there's anything that could happen here.
You have
them.
I am sure you have many pleasantries for me, but please don't bother. Talk of meat. No.
Nothing there. Could be attempt to go against the Quadians. No. Vandals are just, well, they're all with the Alaman anyways. Thuringians, war with the Alaman. Swabians, war with Quadians, but they haven't really done anything there. Roxolanians, war with a bunch. Quadians, war with several, and a tributary of the Roxolanians. Picts me, and so on there. Me. Perhaps we can make peace
with
them.
Welcome, speed.
Nope, they're not too keen on that.
You have the ear of my people.
I might as well see if we can't make some.
Come, let me.
Oh, there we go. Dukes at least. That's a problem. Not yet, reminds me of the Swabians. Could we perhaps also get them so I don't have to at least worry about them directly?
I am sure you have many pleasantries for me, but please don't bother.
Actually, let's ask for money from them.
Not honey.
To bolster our coffers. Actually, got plenty there. There you go. And a bit on actually making peace.
Come, let me hear you.
Guess the rest aren't
my
too
time
keen, but
is
still.
Spent.
Managing the threats one by one does give us a bit more room for sort of, you know,
I have little
surviving, and that's going to be important here as the Western Roman Empire. I'll probably also be good training for Total War Warhammer, which you'll
welcome.
Perhaps even try and play there on Legendary. So that's certainly going to be something there as well. But still, that gives a bit of boost, giving us more room for actually throwing more men into our armies here and there. Of course, we've got rebels everywhere still to deal with.
Ready for orders.
Rightish, still training up there.
At your command.
Right, going down there.
Make haste, men.
And throwing on some bits here. How's this? Might he not be a troublesome person? There we go. Next, we'll try and pressure the Alaman's capital for a bit there. Armies that could stand to get a bit more. We'll just sort of buff up with a few step levies just to add some more infantry, some more raw power here versus the barbarians and all the things that are happening about there. That would probably be pretty good for an idea. But yeah, I should ask money for the sweep, but I only realized it right about to click then. Oh shit. So that wasn't good there again. That was a lot of, not a lot, but still notable resources I could have gained for the glory of Rome and to pay off troops and so on. But yeah, still under a lot of pressure from a lot of sides, so That's going to be tricky. At least I've sort of brought them in there. They could perhaps deal with them. Governor there. All right. So there's wealth for increased wealth, if possible. They need a food. Looking at the situation there, there's not a lot of options there for more. So we're going to have to bring down something. Problem is that means, you know, ruining the economy somehow. Or the sanitation. Which means more disease. But problem is I've hurt the economy somehow. So I'm going to have to take down the public fountain. That's going to hurt me down the road. Of course, yeah, I can't take down any of these because they provide public orders. So it's basically the public fountains. Less sort of penalties there. Plus I can sort of bring in some food issues there. Good lord, yeah, I'm going to need a lot of farms here soon. Need to build up quickly there, set up some cornfields to sort of help with that, otherwise that's going to quickly turn ugly. Alright, let us end the turn, see what happens. Danian's going for Corinium now. Defensive setup, just a quick peek. I mean, overall, I'm not really in condition to fight them, but yeah, no. I could try, but problem is, there's just too many. Just too many. Right, they moved out, so I can actually deal with that a bit better now. Plus, they've suffered some attrition due to moving out in the winter. Ostrogoth staying back. Alamance moving about a bit as well, though some seem to be pulling back. That's good. Langobards looking a bit threatening there. But I quickly need to take care of the Separatists, otherwise I'm going to be suffering a lot of penalties in the longer run, and I do not want to suffer those. So that needs to be dealt with swiftly and painfully. If possible, I need to extort some more money through different means, possibly forcing them into peace somehow. Buy myself some time, resources, and so on there. Western Roman Separatists moving towards their own realm there. African Separatists taking care of the Gatulians, and these are going up there to attack my army by the looks of it. Not good, not in a fighting condition. Need to pull back towards his parlies, I guess. We got more rebels. Ah, Spain is just looking to be one big mess down there soon. Trying to focus more resources into, say, Italy. First up here, food. So much food.
At your command. We hunger for battle.
So many bloody rebels. Ready for orders.
You have
Tetland Chicken.
We take this settlement!
Alright, it looked like they ready could, but for some battle. Reason they can't.
To
I deal
victory.
With the living rebels. Yeah, that's easy. Take that, you traitorous swine.
That I were as swift as the angel. Let them cower like kenneled dogs.
Got those hanging about there. Forest wolves. I might be able to take that with my Commander. Imperial army.
We hunger for battle.
See what it looks about here. Then again, they pull back the army. Yeah, pull back. For the time being.
At your command.
Right in the open.
Ready for battle.
I could front some mercenaries, bulge to my ranks here. They got a lot of cavalry, they got some archers, of course they got the Funditores, which means rather in some sense I've actually got the advantage there. They don't quite have a lot of range, but the thing is they have such an absurd high rate of fire, they can generally tear a lot of things apart there if they aren't armoured, and the Celts are not armoured. That's for sure, and I gotta defend his bonus. Actually, we'll hold to Malakat.
I want hourly patrols.
Trying to rebuild again. Build up, actually, in the first place. There's not really much rebuilding to be done there. At Ravenna. I don't need a rally field there, actually. Guardhouse, Aquileia. It's a bit of a vital point, so we'll keep that one there, actually. Tarentum. Food wise, alright. Morale wise, not so good there. It's causing all the problems, religious differences, taxes, of course, the difficulty, characters, events. Something up. Oh, that's good. That should help a bit then, bringing slightly less issues about. Of course, I'm going to need an army down there as well. Damn it. That's going to be fun.
Ready for orders.
Now then. Ah, they're fortified.
We hunger for battle.
Dead.
Ready for orders. At your command.
Yeah, if you can take care of the public order, that's... Well, the separatists again, that should also help with public order, which is rather...
Light, and there go
all these supporters. We should be able to quickly discharge them and take them out. There we go. Dead, all of them. Not a man alive.
Ready for orders.
So there we go.
At your command.
Need to do whatever I can to keep order, integrity, and so on there. He's not really popular either, this guy. He's certainly not making things easier, that's for sure.
We hunger for battle.
Not one thing too expensive either, but I just want some extra numbers when I go to battle against those people there. Bit tricky here, I'd rather wish for some spearmen. Can. Mercenary Celtic expand. Let's just get some skirmishes, more of them.
For God himself!
Alright, Danians, some spear, some warriors, some units ranged there, and a lot of cavalry. If we can deal with the cavalry, the rest should fall. The Tories again. Really impressive rate of fire. And again, just really good at taking out. The other thing is about the Celtic units is they have small shields, which means they don't really have much cover for a lot of artillery or range fire as well. So that rather gives me another advantage. So I'm really just counting on the Funditore just winning me through this to a certain extent. Oh, I don't need fog. There we go. There you go. The key to victory is rocks being hurled at high speeds. Of course, we got our mighty legions here. Mix of Limitani and a lot of cohorts and some other bits thrown in for good measure.
Palatina guards! For God in heaven! Has been kind today.
Okay, they're also moving. Let's not move too far then. Some of the cohorts just to sort of help with the cavalry swiftly, also my own cavalry. The rest will sort of be pushed into the center.
Warriors, eager for blood!
Or they'll just be tearing their part. No, no. So they're not quite eager moving in either.
Missile infantry ready.
I think the owls have roughly the same range as archers, actually. There's just a slight move here for the Celts, the Abdanians. Ah, most of the cavalry spear raiders that does limit some of the worries I have. Slightly.
Funditores!
Funditores! Okay, precision shot is also a pretty handy ability. Not one actually present in Age of Shaolin. In fact, a lot of the advanced abilities are gone there. Awfully nodding there. And then you're also looking yourself up.
You there!
Right. Just doing this cautiously. No reason to rush in too quickly until we sort of bits. Ah, they have a slightly higher range than my Fundy Tortoise. Suffering some losses there, I think.
Banditores! Double time! Double time! Demis Amatore! Quick march! Missiles are waiting targets! Cohorts!
There you go, the archer's just being slaughtered there by my Funditores. Again, they. Like machine guns to fire rocks.
Enemy units have been rallied.
It's not really the best thing ever. Just, you know, again, if you're fighting Celts, really seem to be not very keen on closer armor. They're the best thing ever.
Quick march! Quick, our men have given up and are running for their lives.
Have you already shattered a bit? Just stumbling apart there as they're getting shot to bits.
As you come out, why you come out at speed. Take aim for glory. God, give us strength.
Catching all the units there in nasty bits. Wonderful. That's going to get very unpleasant once the javelins begin flying into their backs.
Demis Amatore! Loose! Move it! Banditores! Demis Amatore!
There you go.
Ah. Pierce their hearts! Demis Amatore!
Basically, depending on the dispersed slaughter, they don't really have much to take on the cohorts from the front because they don't have any sort of axe units. It's a bit lacking there, and the javelins and the Funditores just slaughtering them. And just notice how many of them have lost already there, just quickly bleeding out. Of course, the skirmish is also taking my units apart. They can. Of course, it's not going quite as straightforward as I'd love to, but sort of consider performance, it's not too bad.
The men have thrown down their weapons and are fleeing.
First, those are broken off.
Given up and are running for their lives.
Banditores!
Warriors are crying! refuses to admit defeat.
The Celtic Warlord is probably one of their more armored units, but that's a strong base they're getting surrounded.
The enemy are losing ground.
There we go. Warlord there. His regiment has collapsed. And the Fundy Tories just keep on killing. So yeah.
Job there, gentlemen. The enemy general is fallen.
There's one skirmish unit left here. Everything else has been killed. Crushed. Beneath the Roman boot.
Get ready! I think it's time for...
And there you go.
Praise the God!
Apparently took heavier losses than expected. Oh, I crushed their army. Spearmen by the looks of it, possibly some of the Fundi Tores, but overall the army has been rendered combat ineffective. That arm's
ready
just
for
a
orders.
Reconfiguration will be good. So, a few units
ready
sort of salvation.
Kill them all.
Just gonna finish it off to ensure they can't be recuperated either.
Make haste, men.
Of course, I might get hunter.
At your
there
command.
We go. Can actually make it back there.
Ready for battle.
Splendid. Another Fundi Tores. A bit more commutatensis spears. So far,
Commander.
There.
Ready for battle.
I'll probably be able to send some of those troops down south here to get to push out the Ostrogoths. Langobards, I'll try and join up with that army, then use. Well, I might actually just
ready
push up here
orders.
With the German tribes first before heading down there. I don't know. We'll figure out. So of course, need to rebuild army. See, I may even have to build another arm to deal with that. Of course, we've still got movement here as well. But then, looks like our friend here might be able to deal with it just in case. So, I'll be moving in my army to support so that doesn't become an actual problem. And here, we should be setting up for some sheep to help with finances just a bit as well. Just a bit as well. And again, with this growth and agricultural building bonuses, we should hopefully do a bit there as well. Sadly, there's no immediate otherwise decreases in upkeep. That's going to be, well, much later here under a new conscription system, which is some way down the road. And I think there's a few others here and there that sort of does the trick. Yeah, a bit there as well. Well, whatever we can do to sort of basically lower the upkeep, the better. It's basically what I figure and what we need. Gotta pull over his start there to sort of keep the economy running while we're losing territory and also fighting numerous battles on numerous fronts. Otherwise, this is not gonna end up well. Now, the governor. Venetia, I guess. Steadfast defender, I suppose, is best there. Yeah, they got the food issues. We are trying to deal with it as well. And hopefully we'll be able to somewhat deal with it as well. Of course, the food and circus is slightly assist the situation, but there's still plenty to work with there. There's still plenty to be done. Oh crap, I forgot about the islands. Damn it. Options for dealing with that are a bit limited. Still, some slight progress this turn, some slight progress. Not a lot, but still we've managed to deal with some threats. We've managed to lower them a bit. What happens next? Danian's up to no good. More rebels. Lindum next target here. This bastard. Now the garrison cut down. Warlocks. Army here's not. Ah, so many hurlers.
Retreat, men! Retreat!
Destination reached.
He's not going to follow. Good. Ah, Langobards crossing in there. Another sizable army. Sources to fight that. Sadly, I don't quite have enough allies there to keep them tied down for the time being.
We will come for you, in the night, and nothing will live. Not one creature.
Assholes. Looks like the Quardians at their province burned to the ground. Ah, phew. I can easily deal with that. Though it does of my Byzantine campaign when it's Palma they're suddenly appearing on. Feels rather reminiscent. Slight chance of defending here. That's going to be close. I'm not look confident with the cavalry and the artillery though. Do have a bit of melee troops there, but I don't know. I think no. So yeah. More losses for the time being. Captures of ground, I guess. So deal with all these bleeding barbarians and
would
the likes.
Would that I were as swift as the angels!
I want hourly patrols.
Yep, town rebels there. This is gonna be fun.
For death and honor!
Oh, my troops are definitely not in a fighting condition, apparently. Plus, which again could actually do some nice damage there. But it carrying other things.
Fall back!
And they're also fortified, actually.
Commander.
Deal with that head on.
At your command. We hunger for battle.
That is looking decent, I guess. Might try and attack there. Financially, things are getting a bit woeful. Have I lost access to Eastern Roman trade? No. Any trade overall? Doesn't seem like it.
Do not attempt to sweeten truth with honey.
Is anyone getting John Wall with?
I'm sure you have many pleasantries for me, but please don't bother. Talk of meat, not honey.
Right. One problem less. I've still got plenty to go.
Welcome. Speak.
What about the Abdanians after took out one of their armies?
You have the ear of my...
They're still keen on fighting. Franks are good friends with us, though they're not quite as keen we make peace with some.
Sit, friend, and let us talk. And let us have good wine until we can talk no more.
Can't quite get them to work with me on much things there, that's unfortunate. The Markomans?
You are welcome, although my ancestors and people expect talk with purpose and honesty.
Again, he's defensive, not likely. But Oxalenians, they were the Quadians, not actually against them.
Speak ill or slowly, and I may feed your tongue to the dogs.
Nope. Feeling my options are a bit limited here. They're still fighting with the Alaman, that's good. Can I actually get these chaps to...
Are you brave?
Nope. Nothing to work with there. What about the Huns? Are there anyone I can sort of...
Speak! I will listen before I turn you inside out.
Guess that is not the case. Wait, what? The Caledonians at war with me? Since when? Assholes.
My time is better spent feasting.
Guess he just joined in. Swine. That's another problem. England is certainly becoming
at your command.
Less and less
ready
functional.
For battle. We need good. At your command. Ready for battle. Ready for orders. Ready for orders.
This is becoming
we hunger for battle.
Tricky. Let me take care of that. Is something, I suppose.
We will march till you.
Bring those back, all the way back. The struggle is very much real here. More farmland being set up. Go do that and farmland here. Much more farmland and
command.
Hopefully some slight boosts to the economy for that. Whatever we can get.
Ready for battle.
And here, I don't know, I suppose I'll move down there. That might actually help be able to deal with the dug in unit there. I'm not keen on giving up on that again. The problem is just I need to concentrate somewhere first. That basically means giving up ground.
Command.
Some meds will have to counterattack and retake.
Commander.
So I can actually contrary again. So I'm going to try and use these to sort of push through here, take Eastern Empire. Actually, I might have to send one down there to help deal with the Italian rebels around Tarentum first, otherwise, that's. Well, they can actually hold out, though. They got a bit to work with there, so Tarentum isn't quite as badly off as, say, other elements of the Empire. But again, we'll try and sort of clear out the elements here. The Ostrogoths, the rebels, sort of push back here, take what is possible. And then we'll sort of, push back up from the north, though. We might send some armies over to Spain, actually. First, we'll sort of shift some elements to Spain, and then we'll make a concerted push back towards the north. I think that will... Kinda work. Kinda. not the best option there, but I don't see so many others at the moment. A bit limited what I can do. Rebels, troubles. More troubles. Ostrogoths are going east. I don't mind that, really. That makes the job easier for me in sort of resecuring the eastern borders of the Empire. Langobards, just no good. Gonna be looking forward to when I move army back to deal with theirs. Basically, the northern part of the Empire is the less profitable anyway, so south, sort of more where the effort is, then we'll put things there. Means I have to pull the Legion back there, I guess. Just not possible now, we just more and more barbarians streaming in. I mean, we'll take it back, just we have to sort of focus down certain elements first, because currently, again, it's just difficult to maintain all those armies in decent fighting condition.
Only the greatest dare speak of peace.
Yep, jolly good, jolly good.
We live for battle. We dream of it. We relish it.
Idiots. Spaniards are definitely quickly becoming an issue. Well, but again, that's going to be some longer fight, I suspect. I gotta deal with them as well. Damn it. First,
lay siege to the settlement. At your command.
For now, move in there to help hold Sabaria. You are them, have seen better days. Fields.
At your command.
Down to Londinium.
Ready for orders.
Octotorum.
Commander.
Should move down there.
God. March! Destroy them!
Not that I'm particularly keen on giving up ground, but again, we have to focus and concentrate.
Ready for orders.
Of course, otherwise, our strength basically means bugger all.
We hunger for battle.
So we have to do what we can do to get the most out of it.
Ready for
order. Kind of,
right. Regroup and fall back.
But I think we'll be stopping you all for joining in. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Not so many battles, mostly just moving about, pulling back from some of the borders, and overall formulating a new strategy for how to sort of defend and, of course, re-expand the empire. So thank you all for joining in. If you like to subscribe, share it, like it, and so on. There's press like. And again, thank you all. Hope to see you all in another 2 days for another exciting episode. This is Imperial Dane signing off for tonight, or today. Cheers.